But I think that a lot of times, you know, love is just this, because we want to hear it.
Right. Right. Mm-hmm.
But when you come and get to discover some things about yourself, it's like, no, baby, I want to feel this.
Yeah.
Right.
I want to experience.
Right. Right.
In all ways that can be felt and experienced, you know.
And when I think about, like, with my parents, I grew up in a house, nobody said I love you, all of those things. It was problematic for once I became a teenager. You know, I thought that was so important. Like, dad, like, why don't they say that? Why don't they say, I love you? Why don't they give hugs? Like, what the fuck? And then, like, when I realized that's what's supposed to happen, then I realized it was something I'm lacking. You know what I mean? So sometimes I feel like people, you can assign, when you realize other people live a certain way, and then you put it on yourself, like, oh, I'm missing that. Everybody has that to function, and I'm missing that. So now I have a deficiency, and I'm reacting and acting on this deficiency. And it's like, well, my parents never said they loved me or whatever. Right. So now I have this crutch or whatever, only because I learned it from outside people that it wasn't okay. But, like, you know, as I got older, I thought about how... and it was more important for my dad, for me to think about my dad in looking for a man. I thought about the ways he came through to show love without ever having to say it. Then I started thinking about all the men that said, I love you, and treated me like shit. Right. So it's like, okay, how important
do I need this? I love you.
How are these words? I mean, now, if I ask you, I still want to know that you love me.
But. Yeah, I think it always takes me back to the August Wilson play Fences. And most people are more familiar with it from Denzel Washington and Viola Davis with the movie or whatever. When the son said to Denzel Washington, his father, you know, sometimes I feel like you don't like me. And his character says, you know, like you, you know, liking you is not in the contract.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And you should be more concerned about doing right by you. I do right by you. I feed you. I perform my duty to you. He said, don't go through this world expecting people to like you. You make sure they're doing right by you.
That part.
And as generations, you know, we're always taught the responsibility of being a father, being a mother, being a husband. So a husband, you know what I mean, is somebody that provides, protects, take care of the wife, take care of the kids, this, that, and the other, da, da, da. So love is always, is infused in duty. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do for my husband, for my wife, for my girlfriend, for my boyfriend. If I'm your boyfriend, I should do this. If I'm your son, I should do this for my mother. If I'm your mother, I should do this for my son. And then there's the euphoric expression of love that I think that at different points we put a premium on different parts of it. Because in a romantic sense, you know, show her that you love her, man, buy her flowers. So you have dudes out here, like, you know, doing this all day, da 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 da. But, you know what I mean, he doesn't make sure your well-being is taken care of. He doesn't care about how you actually feel. I bought you Prada, so you should be good. That's you know, there's these expressions of love, but they don't perform their duty to the human being.